Overlighted by Archangel Michael, December 2023, Sixth Dimensional City of Light, Ascended Master Cosmic Council, by Ranava Zane, Sacred Scribe. Rana's Rite of Passage, Part 1, Lady Faith. Much has transpired, and my picture of reality has changed drastically since the incident with Lady Faith in early July 2022. I got up at 6 a.m. after a quite restless, uncomfortable night. As usual, I went into my dressing room and sat down on my stool before the bathroom counter and wash basin to begin my ablutions. I felt a deep sense of sadness and despair, which has not occurred in a long time. It has been many years since I have done this. However, speaking to Archangel Michael, I said, "It has been a long time since I have felt this way. I really need some insight. You know, I really want to stay and complete whatever it is you wish me to do. However, not this way. Not with all this constant turmoil within my mind and body. I feel like I'm losing control of myself." What happened next was really strange. All of a sudden, my spine seemed to stretch upward and my arms automatically lifted straight out at shoulder level, forming a cross. After a brief time, they lifted straight up over my head, symbolic of my pillar of light. I then started to vibrate all over, including my head, which moved from side to side very rapidly. I don't know how long it lasted, however, it really was one of the most violent download episodes I have ever experienced. As in the past, I was told to relax and stay with it. After a short time, I felt a bolt of energy shoot down my spine. It was powerful and awesome, but not uncomfortable. It was like Archangel Michael's energy feels when it comes in full force before a seminar, only stronger. Not uncomfortable, just very strong and forceful. I always feel like I have to stretch to accommodate it. Lady Faith then came through telepathically, loud and clear, saying to me, "As I have told you many times, I have always been with you, positioned behind your left shoulder. However, you have now fully merged the right and left hemispheres of your brain, so that my beloved counterpart and I may reunite. Therefore, you will no longer see or sense us as separate or apart. Once more, we have merged into one unified consciousness. It was only you who perceived us being separate or felt we were divided. In this lifetime, I had to step back into a support position, for I have been with you as your primary guiding energy force for so many lifetimes. An important part of your spiritual mission for this lifetime was that you accept your personal power and the divine will of the Father. You have accomplished this admirably. So now I may, once again, be your comforter. Since that time, I feel somewhat different. I feel my balance is somewhat better, even though my head and bodily auric field seem greatly expanded. I don't know how it's going to manifest, in what way or how quickly. For several years now, since I reunited with my sacred triad, and I am more fully within Archangel Michael and Lady Faith's force field, it seems they are no longer separate from me. We are united, so it's very different. It is more of a unity consciousness, and our communications are more a telepathic knowingness. I just have to shift my consciousness to tune in. I have been told there are many starseed soul groups now in the process of merging into their new fifth dimensional hologram. However, first we must traverse a null zone of adjustment. We need to understand that we will always have some small issues that need to be harmonized. We are human, and we still must interact with others to clear the small distortions and tie up the loose ends before we can move forward into more refined frequencies of light. Lady Faith tells us that everything is accelerating so fast, and the starseed souls are receiving as much of their Aquarian divine blueprint as they can manage. It is as if we are in a completely different energetic environment of which our bodily forms are not accustomed. It is going to take time to integrate and assimilate the higher frequency energy so that we may use it efficiently for our maximum benefit and the benefit of all humanity. We are learning how to step down the energy into our linear conscious mind so that we may still manage the little everyday linear left brain tasks. We have to practice using our lower fourth dimensional conscious mind again. It is much more difficult to remember a lot of trivial things, and our short-term memory is very erratic. After an Archangel Michael channeling session at a big seminar, I used to say it takes time to get my genie back in the bottle. These days, shifting back and forth between dimensions is a common occurrence. We truly are walking between the worlds, accessing multiple dimensional frequency patterns. For a long time, we have focused on accessing our sacred mind and our higher self, as well as integrating the right and left hemispheres of our brain. Now we must get used to gradually integrating the higher frequency 5D energy patterns into our unified conscious mind, while staying grounded within our 4D material plane environment. So how does the above information relate to the uncomfortable feelings we are experiencing? We are mutating and evolving very quickly. Through all of 2022 and the first 4 months of 2023, it has been building up, off and on. However, now it is almost constant. For me personally, it is not that I feel tired or weak. However, I seem to feel off balance more frequently. It is the brain and bodily disturbances and the complicated transformation process we are in the midst of that is creating the unusual sensations and discomfort. To a degree, I believe we are the forerunners, or we are laying the groundwork for those brave souls of the distant future who will actually ascend in the physical vessel. We certainly are not ready to do that at this time. However, we are opening the way for future humanity. Archangel Michael has said to me many times, "In this lifetime you will be integrating energy that the physical vessel is not prepared to accommodate. Also, the accelerated transformational process is more difficult for those in an older physical vessel. So it is highly probable that we will continue to experience strange symptoms and powerful intermittent surges of energy. It is important that we listen to our body intelligence and strive to take advantage of any new concepts that we feel are right for us, even those which do not fit modern society's beliefs and standards." Memory Seed Activators by Rana, Sacred Scribe. My divine blueprint as a sacred scribe and messenger for Archangel Michael and Lady Faith consists of bringing forth specific portions of the new higher frequency wisdom teachings to assist humanity to move through the final phases of the ascension process of the third, fourth dimensional environment. This is a requirement if we are to attain entrance into our new fifth dimensional world of tomorrow. First, we must move through a preparatory stage, or a null zone, which is situated within two separate membranes of light. It serves as a barrier to the entry level of the fifth dimensional hologram. There are a great number of people on Earth who are memory seed activators at many different levels. This is so that the different memory seed atoms, the different crystalline structures, and the different sacred sites or ley lines within the Earth can be activated at the appropriate time. This process has been designed so that at the appropriate time the necessary energy can be supplied to activate these sacred energy centers. It is a vitally important part of the divine blueprint, a co-creative endeavor designed to occur between humanity and the Earth. All of the activators who will initiate the necessary changes for the Earth and humanity are part of a cooperative effort amongst Gaia, humanity, and the great Lords of Light, under the direction of our Father Mother God, to assist in and facilitate the great migration into the New Age realms of tomorrow. Rana's Rite of Passage, Part 2, by Rana Zane, Sacred Scribe. Fifth Dimensional Memory Seed Atom Download. After a huge download of higher frequency memory seed atoms and the amazing telepathic message from Lady Faith in early July of this year, the sixth dimensional City of Light Cosmic Council began communicating with me. They identified themselves as the Ascended Masters Cosmic Council of 12. I have been told that I am now a disciple initiate of the Ascended Masters Cosmic Council of 12 as a messenger of the advanced teachings of the future. which are sorely needed by humanity as the masses begin to prepare to move into null zones of the fourth dimension, and also into preparation for humanity's ascension into the entry level of the fifth dimension. I am somewhat uncomfortable relaying this information to the public. However, I was told it is appropriate that I share this important information at this time, for there are vast numbers of brave and faithful starseed souls who are also within the last phases of the fourth dimensional ascension process. They are now ready to join the various cosmic councils of light. Archangel Michael also told me that I am now ready to receive guidance directly from the higher cosmic councils of light via the new sixth dimensional central communication center. I am humbled and so very blessed to be given this grand opportunity and to be included in the chosen ones who relay these vitally important wisdom teachings for the new age of enlightenment to our beloved soul families and friends around the world. July 8, 2022, in my morning meditation, the Ascended Masters Cosmic Council of 12 began to speak to me telepathically. I also began to receive amazingly beautiful clear pictures, colors, and what appeared to be streams of radiant light pouring into my third eye. Beginning on August 18th, 2023, I began channeling longer, more important messages from the Ascended Masters Cosmic Council of Light at various times, especially in the mornings. My home faces east and I love basking in the early morning sun. All through the rest of July, August, and September, I continued to receive downloads of information from the Ascended Masters Cosmic Council of Light. The various Cosmic Councils of Light and the Ascended Masters Cosmic Council of Light were explained to me in detail. Many of the articles in the second section of High Vibes Master Teacher's Manual were given to me over those amazing 3 months, and the new fifth dimensional cosmic teachings keeps pouring in. Some in bits and pieces, and some large, very detailed, and often in surprising articles. Ascended Masters, Cosmic Councils of Light. Yeshua is the Lord of Love. Buddha is the Lord of Light. Archangel Michael and Lord Melchizedek are the overlighting masters of all of the Cosmic Councils of Light. I understand that there are various levels of Cosmic Councils within our subuniverse. Cosmic Council of 3. Fourth dimensional information. Cosmic Council of 6, solar system information. Cosmic Council of 9, galactic information. Cosmic Council of 12, subuniversal information. Members of the Ascended Masters Cosmic Council have had many earthly lifetimes, and all of them have ascended from the earth plane. Therefore, they have united to give us information necessary to move through the final stages of the fourth dimension and into the null zone in preparation to qualify to ascend into the entry level of the fifth dimension. Also, they are very different frequency level consoles who will supply the advanced information we will need as we make the shift into our fifth dimensional world of reality. Also, I have been told by Archangel Michael that there are several within our core soul group who will eventually take over where he and the Ascended Masters Cosmic Council of Light left off with the teachings through me over the past 30 years. These new messengers will use the information and teachings already provided, adding their unique reservoir of memory seed atoms so that they may share new, upgraded information needed to guide humanity through the final dark nights of the soul and the null zone. Dearest friends, as a group of world servers, you are the designated teachers, wayshowers, and vanguard souls whose mission is to provide user-friendly, easy-to-apply tools, techniques, and guidance through these end times. You are being guided, directed, and inspired to access, integrate, and share the enlightening, illuminating, and empowering teachings within the new divine blueprint for the age of Aquarius. Blessings beyond measure await each precious soul who answers the new clarion call. Won't you join us? Eternal love and angel blessings, and big hugs to each of you. Rana.